Namaskar, myself Pratik, and in this session, we are going to discuss the concept of cursor. Let us start this session. Cursor is a memory or work area that Oracle Engine uses for its internal processing, for executing and storing the result of SQL statement. And this work area is reserved for all SQL operations. This area of memory reserved by Oracle is known as cursor. For example, when a user fires a select statement like select column name from table name where condition, then all the rows returned by the query are stored in the cursor at the server and will be displayed to the client end. So we can conclude that whenever we execute any SQL statement like insert, update, delete, or select, then Oracle need an internal area of memory for its successful execution. And this area of memory, which is reserved by Oracle for execution and storing the results of SQL statement, is known as cursor. For example, let us consider this select statement. Here we are selecting some columns from table employee where department number is 10. The result of this query will be stored in an internal area of memory, and that internal area of memory is called as cursor. So this active data set is actually a cursor area which store all the columns and rows returned by this query. And this area of memory is called as cursor. There are two type of cursors. One is implicit cursor and second is explicit cursor. It means that this area of memory can be defined implicitly by the Oracle, or a user can also define it explicitly. We will discuss the concept and implementation of implicit cursor and explicit cursor in this section. And in next video session, we will discuss implicit cursor. To read more about this, you can refer my book Simplified Approach to DBMS, which is available on Amazon. You are requested to subscribe to this YouTube channel to receive latest video tutorials on topics like data mining, machine learning, DBMS, big data, NoSQL, and many more. To learn SQL in a simplified way, you can join this free online course on SQL at Udemy platform. I have also authored books on data mining and data warehousing, NoSQL, beginning with SQL, and PLSQL for beginners. All these books are available at Amazon platform. To read more about this, you can refer my website pratikbhatia.com. Thanks for watching this video.